Hi, this is Ms. Beauty Bio, and today we're going to talk about the chemistry behind a fake tan.
Let me tell you folks, fake tans, they love me. The tans that I'm seeing in America right now are very bad. They're a disaster. I know tans, I have the best fake tan in the world. The best thing that I can do for this country is to make it tan great again.
Wow. Whether it's a spray, lotion, mousse, or wipe, all artificial tans have one key ingredient, DHA, or dihydroxyacetone. This three-carbon white crystalline powder sounds scary, but it's really just a non-toxic, simple sugar that comes from beets, sugarcane, or the fermentation of glycerin. The skin-coloring properties of DHA were first discovered in the 1920s when Procter & Gamble tested it as a sugar substitute for diabetics, though the idea proved unsuccessful after it left hard-to-remove brown spots on the faces of test subjects. Almost 40 years later, it was rediscovered and commercially released as Mantan. Have you ever tried to caramelize or brown a steak? Well, DHA is caramelizing you. It reacts with amino acids in the stratum corneum, the outer layer of skin, turning you a golden brown. It's called the Maillard reaction, and it's behind the golden hue of beer, the smell of bacon, and everything else that makes life worth living. Some people say when they apply fake tanner, the smell has a raw, meaty quality. This is because the chemical reaction produces thousands of aromatic compounds. One of those is thiophenes, a sulfur-based compound that smells of meat. Now, a fake tan might look like the real thing, but it's not.
Miss Beautifile, my tan is better than the real thing. It's very orange, it's very special.
Yes, it's very unique, and your signature tangerine color involves a little chemistry. Skin with an alkaline pH tends to turn orange, and your natural composition of amino acids can also affect a fake tan's final hue. According to this chart, Mr. President, your skin has a little more arginine than most. Thankfully, some tanning products are trying to influence the final color by offering a two-compartment dispenser that offers DHA on one side and select amino acids that favor more golden hues on the other to tweak that final shade for a more natural look.
I'm sticking with the orange. It looks great with my hair. Just great.
Since DHA only reacts with the stratum corneum, the color gets darker in areas where the outer layer of skin gets thicker, like the elbows, the knuckles, the knees, and soles.
Elbows, knuckles, knees, and toes, knees, and toes, knees.
Freckled, aged, and rough skin also takes up color unevenly, which is why experts encourage you to hit the loofah first. Tans also fade in about 2 weeks after the upper layer of the stratum corneum flakes off. Now, a fake tan is very different from a suntan. A real tan happens when exposure to the sun kicks off melanin production. The melanin absorbs some of the harmful UV radiation, protecting you from further damage. A fake tan does not offer the same protection. And if you're going outdoors without sunscreen, you're gonna get burned.
Thanks to me, we're gonna have so many fantastic tans. America will tan great again. We're going to lead the charge, close the tanning trade gap, and even make Mexico pay for it. That Miss Beautifile, she's a really nasty woman. She's a 4 instead of a 10. You should still subscribe and like her channel because she knows her chemistry.
I like it.